better place. We have what it takes to make our world a better place. We are smart at what we do to make our world a better place. We are smart at what we do to make our world a better place. By the help of God, to make our world a better place.
All fine. Previously in cash book we discussed different types of cash book. One of them was single column cash book, double column cash book, and a three column cash book. Today I want us to see an example of a three column cash book. Aforementioned three column cash book has got the three columns of discounts, cash, and bank. So today I want to show you an example. So on 1st December 2006, Sora Traders had cash in hand, 25,000, and shillings 56,200 at bank. The following transactions took place during the month. We have December 2nd, cash sales 42,000, 5th, received a check of 70,500 from Mwaura after he had deducted 6% discount. You must understand that language over there. That is after he had deducted 6% discount. On 8th, paid salaries 24,000 in cash. On 9th, Ole Kivui settled his account of 45,000 in cash and was allowed a discount of 1,800. Then we have on 12, we have cash sales of 46,500, and we also have on 18th paid a debt of 100,000 by check after deducting 5% discount. This means that we are going to calculate the 5% from the 100,000. Then on 24th, we withdrew 26,000 from the bank for office use. This is a contra entry. So we are going to write here contra entry because the money was taken from the bank and was moved to the cash tills where it was used for the office. Then we have on 29, paid for lighting and heating 8,750 in cash. Then we have banked all the cash except 25,000. I want us to mark this one properly. Banked all the cash except 25,000. So we are required to prepare a three column cash book. And here is the solution. After we have known all that where the discounts are in percentage, we are going to calculate those percentages. For example, we have on 5th received 70,500 from Maura after deducting 6% discount. So it means 6% of what we don't know. This 75, what we don't know is 75,000, simply because 70,500 represent 94,000. So we are going to calculate what is represented by the 6%. And when we do our math, 6 times 70,500 divided by 96, we get 4,500. That is the amount that is the amount in cash of the discount that was allowed to Mwaura. Then we have on December 18 paid to less date of 100,000. Yes? So we are going to calculate the 5% of 100,000. So 100,000 simply represent 100%. So we are going to say what percentage, what amount is represented by 5%. So it is 5 times 100 1,000 divided by 100, which is equal to 5,000. So I want to show you something I've hidden, which is the three-column cash book. And as you can see, we must have what we call heading. So heading is Swara Traders, three-column cash book. On this side we have debit, on the other side we have credit. Everything that is on the debit, it is a receipt, okay? Receipt. And everything that is on the credit side is called payment. So all the payments are going to be recorded on the other side. All the receipts are going to be made on this other side. Whom do we pay? Those we owe money. For example, those we bought from, we purchased from somebody, we have to pay them. Who do we receive from? Those we have sold to. So, we have here, December 1st, as mentioned, we have on December 1st, 2006, Swara Traders had cash in hand, 25,000, and 56,200. We are going to record that under balance brought down, because it is money that is brought in from the other business which existed before. So balance brought down, we have cash 25,000 and 56,200 as we have seen. On second, we had a transaction which was a cash sales of 42,000. So we are going to record that under we have sales. We are recording this as a general ledger because nobody's name has been mentioned. So we have 42,000. And then we move to fifth, Mwaura. Mwaura, now a name is mentioned and it is a sale. So Mwaura, we had calculated the the amount in this the discount in amount that was given. So it is 4,500 and it affected the bank because it was a check. We received a check. Then we have Ole Kibui, which we sold to, who gave us 43,200 after we had given him a discount of 1,800. Then we have on 12, we have the general ledger because it is a sales. Nobody's name has been mentioned, which is 46,500. Then we have on 24th, bank. We have a contra entry on 24th where we withdrew 26,000 from the bank for office use. So we are going to take out of the bank on the other side, and we are going to input is in our cash, because this side is receipt and this side is payment. So the bank will pay 26,000, and what will happen? The cash will receive that 26,000 that has been paid. And then we have on 29, where we paid for lighting in cash. So payment on 29. We have payment of 87.50. Then we have on 31st, we banked all the cash except 25,000. So having known that we have some money, we are going to calculate all the money that we have in cash. This is the receipt. So we are going to add 25,000, 42,000, 43,000, 46,000, 26,000. Then we know what we are getting, okay? So we will find out that we have 24,950 plus 25,000, which is 149,950. But remember, we were told except 25,000. So we are going to take out that 25,000. We get that we are going to bank a total of 124
1000. So this one here is 182. Yeah. So we are banking it, the amount that we have taken out, we are banking it here on, that is on 31st, 124,950. So it's not supposed to be here. Okay, so it has been taken out there, it has been inputted here. So we start adding the columns. This column, then we find that this is the total amount, this is the total amount. We do a double line, and when you have a space remaining like this one, you put something so that nobody can ever come and record any transaction which will affect your figures. So, as we were told, 25,000 is the balance that was left in the bank. We have 130,650 to be carried forward. Thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed the lesson.